All right, how's it going, guys? So not that bad of a week, honestly. We got a cat yesterday, and she's still trying to get settled, so probably won't see her today, but it'll probably show up in a couple other videos later on. Her name is Buttons. She's really, really nice. She is really well adjusted already for just gotten her yesterday, and yeah, it's kind of great. Awesome RPG mechanics, epic FPS gameplay, storyline and twist, and then you throw in Handsome Jack. Borderlands 2. I mean, that's kind of true, but I feel like Jack just fits underneath the storyline and the twist because a lot of the game is revolvent around him. And you could replace that last one with like the bugs that are in the game because some of them are like really fun and useful, and other ones make your guns disappear through the floor and crash your game. So, yeah, those are noteworthy. How long have you played Borderlands 2? About 1200 hours. Wow, you must be very good at the game then, right? Yeah. I mean, even I have almost like 5,000 hours at this point, and whenever you get to OP 10 and you're fighting raid bosses, it's just ridiculous. Either you get it immediately or you just suffer immediately, and you really don't know until you play. It's kind of rough, and I kind of don't like that it's a thing, but unfortunately, Borderlands 2 is just a very steeply curved game because they didn't really plan it that well. So, this just happens to everybody. My boyfriend ignores me for Borderlands 2. Okay, I've seen this post, and I have seen some people say, oh, this is probably just a grab post to get people's attention and upvotes and stuff. But if it really is a dude that just ignores you to play Borderlands 2, it's not the game at that point, it's just kind of the dude. And it's really unfortunate that it's like that, but yeah, that's just a dude problem. Unsettling figure found in sanctuary. Oh. Yeah, anytime that I play with friends, I always try to get into their cameras and stuff at all times too. It's kind of fun. I don't know why, especially like if they're streaming and they're in their inventory a lot. You just get up next to them and then you just turn around and look where you think their camera is and just stare at it really hard. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't, but most of the time it's kind of funny. If Sham Infinity isn't the best combo, explain this. Okay. I just want to point out how many times they're missing boar here. Like, look at this. They get one good one right there. That's a really, really nice chunk. And then just nothing for like forever. I don't know if they're missing on purpose for a lot of this, but it's kind of rough. And also, the Jacob's Infinity is so stupid. I know it's a mod. I know you have to bug the game or mod the game to get it to work and like get it in. But it's really funny to watch that hammer fan, especially if you can get a higher fire rate than this, because then the hand just almost doesn't move off of the back of the hammer, and it just looks absurd. So this is in Tails, I believe, and I just want to know who was in charge of this scene, because that is the barrel of the rocket launcher. And this is the exhaust of the rocket launcher. I don't know why it is in the worst possible quality ever. That's kind of unfortunate. But yeah, like back end, front end. I don't know who was in charge of this. I don't know if they just had some intern do it really quick, probably for the scene. But this just kind of worries me about how much they actually know about the games that they create whenever they're creating stuff like this. Because who has a car like that? Who has a backwards rocket launcher? That bull loader, you know, like just exists and its shield is weird. It's just weird. I don't know. I don't know how I feel about the Telltales. I hope the second one's good though. Clipping during the bunker fight to meet Terramorphis. Oh, yeah, you can totally do this. Yeah. So basically, you do a skip that would normally get you out of bounds and help you get down the elevator faster. But instead of going down the elevator, you just kind of go off to the side and roam around. I don't know why they're going in here. They don't need to. But yeah, you can just get out of bounds. The way they're doing it is a little bit rough, a little bit weird of a choice. But it does get you out there. And then you can just walk all the way over to Terra's arena. You see Terra here just kind of doing his thing. I mean, it's supposed to just be a funny little Easter egg that you see you see Terra before you're supposed to, and that's all it's really meant to be. So, yeah, I don't know. This is it. Yeah. What's this weird box with the default texture under the map? Okay, so in a lot of the maps in Borderlands 2, there's a little checker box that is where you spawn. That's all it is. Whenever you first load in, your character spawns there. They're red, their gear is all figured out, and then they're thrown up top. Sometimes it doesn't even do that. Sometimes it just puts you there for a split second before putting you wherever you're supposed to go on the map. But typically that's all they're really used for, and there's nothing else that's really incredible or noteworthy about them. They're just a little box. BA rank reset help. Okay. Me, myself, I wouldn't really mind if my badass rank reset, I'll be honest with you, because having high bar is sort of unfair. I feel like if you're playing multiplayer with friends, it's not as extreme, especially if you only have like 10, 20, 30% buffs. But for the people who have the fake modded bars or they did the glitches to get like the 200 or 300%, those are obviously ridiculous. But oh well, you've lost minor fake stats that most people don't even have, and you can still totally play the game just fine. Master Grenadier, level 50 Axton with 23 grenades and the Firestorm Nade mod. Okay. So this is hopefully good. You could have more stockpile here. This is a curse. Why is it trying... What is it trying to load? Oh, okay. It's split screen. Okay. So it's split screen, which kind of hurts. We got the plus 3 there. We've got the 10 on that. So we have 23 nades. That's it? Wait, are we gonna show it? Please, no. Show it in action at least, if you're gonna make a video about it. Alright, well I guess they just wanted to show us how many grenades they have. Good for you, I guess. I don't know. You can have more as Axton, because you can get a bigger max nade comm, and then you can also get a bigger stockpile relic for it too. So like, those can get higher even. But, cool I guess. Who is the hardest character to 100% with? Okay, so in my mind, it is Krieg. And the reason that it is Krieg is simply because a lot of people don't know how to use a Krieg. And I guess I mainly play in OP levels where you really, really have to know how to play Krieg properly. I guess technically you could get the 100% in your normal mode playthrough and it wouldn't be nearly as bad. And honestly, at that point, you do get to have the release the beast probably towards the end of your playthrough, and that'll be super strong there. But yeah, he's still just harder. His hitbox is heavier than everybody else's, like his player's model's weight or whatever it is, so he can't grenade jump to skip stuff. So he does just take the longest to get places and do stuff. But everyone else is pretty fairly tied for the most part, except for Salvador, obviously. Salvador can just rocket jump everywhere and then one-shot everything, and it just makes him absolutely overpowered, and he is definitely the easiest. Alright, and that is it for this week. There wasn't really anything else of note. I kind of have to keep it short for today. The cat is still one day new to the house. So we have to make sure she doesn't eat plants or cords or stuff like that, you know. But that's it. Leave a like if you liked the video. Leave a comment if you have any ideas. Maybe subscribe if you haven't. I'd appreciate it. And that's it. Hope you guys have a nice rest of your week. See you later.